Zangoose's unique ability Toxic Boost gives it a 1.5 times boost on its physical attacks. Paired with the move Facade, which power doubles from 70 to 140 base power when poisoned, this thing can hit extremely hard. Most often people give Zangoose the Toxic Orb held item, which allows it to poison itself. However, with a base speed of only 90, it often gets outran before it can go off. Which is why I've got a crazy plan. I can use Glamora to set up Toxic Spikes on the opponent's side of the field when they hit me, and then the Eject button allows me a direct switch into Cinderace, who can then use its signature move Court Change. Court Change swaps all the effects on the field, bringing the spikes to my side. Now, when Zangoose switches into battle, it gets immediately poisoned, which frees up its held item slot. I can now give Zangoose a Choice Scarf, which boosts its speed by 1.5 times, and it's finally a fast attacker that hits like an absolute truck. Ladies and gentlemen, what is happening? Welcome back to another Scarlet and Violet Wi-Fi battle with probably one of my craziest strategies yet. Listen, is it super competitively viable? Probably not. Am I still crazy enough to try to get it to work? Absolutely. Hey, if you're into that kind of thing, consider hitting that subscribe button. I'm on my way to 300k, and I promise you will not regret it. Let's go ahead and get into the match. Alright, so my opponent is going to go ahead and lead off with the goopiest Gooperton in town, and I decide to toss out the Hisuian Electrode. This thing is an absolute monster and slept on. That's a whole nother conversation. However, they're going to turn into me, of course, and we're just a couple of round dudes being guys. So at this point, we don't actually have much to do to each other, so we both decide to go for a Volt Switch here. They end up going first because they're Choice Scarf Ditto, and that's actually fine by me, because what that does is allows me to get a Volt Switch on whatever they bring in, and then I can grab the matchup and a little bit of momentum on my side. So they go into Dragapult. Now, Dragapult's a little bit of an issue, kind of for the strategy of my team, of course, because a couple of ghost types being around with that and the Golden Go, I cannot go for the Facade. So definitely going to have to figure out a plan working around these ghosts, but for now, I decide to go into the Glamora. I'm thinking this thing likely goes for a physical attack, sets up our Toxic Spikes, activates our Eject button, and then we can get started. However, they're actually going to end up switching out, and I go for the Earth Power knowing that I can't freely go for a Sludge Wave, of course. With the Golden Go being around, this thing does actually come in, and we are going to hit his Cinnamon Toast Crunch ass. Cinnamon is the Winamon with a nice little Earth Power, so it's not quite enough to knock it out. And I don't really want to stay in here. I know that I want to conserve my Glamora as much as possible. Essentially, I need it to be hit with a physical attack to get my Toxic Spikes up, to get my plan to all come together. So I decide to go into the Ambipom. I know that I can take an attack from this thing, but it actually ends up going for the trick here. So it turns out that it's going to be Choice Scarf, and that's going to be fine with Ambipom. I'm now the fastest mon on this side of the Mississippi, and we just basically kind of trade scarfs here. So I figure, hey, I actually kind of look nice in this one, so I'm just going to go for a nice little knockoff. And with the Choice Scarf outspeeding everything, there's not a lot that wants to get their item knocked off. So they decide to switch into Clefable. Listen, the bane of my existence is one of the Pokemon that you just hate to play against. Clefable is always way too damn good. And at least getting rid of that leftover is going to kind of hinder its ability to at least be that annoying. So now at this point, I figure I might as well just go into Glamora. This thing is likely going to go for something like a Calm Mind. And if I get in this fella, I can go for some Sludge Waves. And start to be annoying. Mostly this thing is here to be a punching bag to get up Toxic Spikes, but I also get the benefit of being a nice poison attacker here. So they decide to go for the Wish, and that leads me to believe they're likely going to switch. And since they've seen the Earth Power play before, I don't imagine they go into Golden Go, but they could potentially bring in something like the Noivern, and that is exactly what they do. They bring in the old skinny Zubat, and of course I can't hit this thing with an Earth Power, and I still find myself in a position where I need to be hit with a damn physical attack to get these Toxic Spikes up. However, it's turning out to be more difficult than we once thought. But, of course, I'm going to end up switching out here. I decide to go Ambipom, knowing that their highest damage output, unless it's Choice Specs, is going to be a Draco Meteor, which I should be able to just barely live one, and then Ambipom can either pivot or, you know, just do some damage. So they do end up going for that Draco Meteor. We are able to take it because of the thickness of these palms, and at this point, I decide to go for a U-turn. I figure there's no way they stay in here. I can U-turn, grab a pivot, and start to try to get a matchup here. And it's kind of an uphill battle when they have mons like this Clefable. They have switch into the Glamora, and it's just trying to get a good positioning here. So I go for that U-turn. They bring in the fat-ass piece of chewed gum, and I decide to just go right back into Glamora. I figure it's going to become kind of a match of, like, they know what I have gone for in the past. And a big part of competitive Pokemon games like this is knowing their playstyle and trying to take advantage of that. So knowing that they've switched in the past, I'm figuring maybe they actually just decide to make a different play here. They end up going for the Protect just to scout what I'm going to go for, and they see the Sludge Wave. So now it puts us in a little bit of a stalemate opportunity here where they know that I'm going to Sludge Wave. They know that I could also predict them to switch into Golden Go and go for their Earth Power. I just decided to go for the obvious play, and it pays off for me. The Sludge Wave does come through, and down goes the Clefable. So, overprediction on their end, and it was kind of just a coin flip situation. So, we'll love to see it. Clefable is gone and taken care of. And now this brings in the Tyranitar. So, I'm sitting in this situation thinking, okay, there's a physical attacker where they can go for the Earthquake, get up my Toxic Spikes, and then I profit. So what I decided to do is go for the Sludge Wave, thinking for sure they go for the Terra Flying. A lot of the time, you do see Terra Flying on the Tyranitar, and I wanted to just get some damage. However, they actually just do not go for that Terra, and they decide to go for the Dragon Dance. And old Reptar going for the Dragon Dances is honestly pretty scary. At this point, I'm figuring, okay, they didn't Terra the turn one. Maybe they Terra this time, going for the Earth Power, but they actually just continue to Dragon Dance. Do not go for that Terra. After the match, they actually mentioned that the Terra would have been too obvious and the Sludge Wave would have done a bunch of damage, but they do not Terra. Sludge Wave does nothing at this point, and I am in danger. I figure this time, screw it, I'm going for that Earth Power. They actually Dragon Dance for a third time here. They figure at plus 3 speed and attack, this thing can take care of my entire team. However, now I just go for that Earth Power. It's going to not be able to knock it out because of the boost this thing gets, being a rock type in the Sandstorm. But what I did do is put it into range where hopefully my best hope at this point is going to be Ambipom. So they are now forced to go for that Earthquake. Of course, that does end up knocking me out, but it also is going to set up my Toxic Spikes. And that's exactly what I finally needed. We're able to get up the Toxic Debris. However, now my plan is I just need to get through this Tyranitar. And it actually turns out to be Life Orb, which is amazing because that actually puts it right into range to where a resisted Fake Out should even kill. Also, with it being Life Orb, it actually would just knock itself out in one more turn anyway. But I bring in the Ambipom, go for the Fake Out, and the little bit of greed on the Dragon Dances there is going to pay off for me. So, the Fake Out takes care of the Tyranitar. We've got our Toxic Spikes up now. I just got to figure out a way to bring those spikes over to my end. So, Tyranitar being a big threat out of the way. Now, I am obviously Choice Scarfed into Fake Out at this point, so they can actually freely go right into Golden Go, and this thing can just be annoying. So, I obviously have to switch here, but luckily Cinderace can actually come in for free on this thing. Essentially, I know that I can take an attack from it and then outspeed, and then I can hopefully go for that court chain. So, young Flambino comes in, ready to play some damn soccer. They go for the Make It Rain. Of course, resisted. It's going to do around half. And this thing also drops its special attack here. So, at this point, I'm thinking I can outspeed, go for that court change, and then it's Zangoose time to basically come in, outspeed, and be toxic boosting all over the damn place. So, they're actually going to go ahead and commit the Terra at this point, and I'm honestly happy to see that because that means no surprise Terras later on, and this thing ends up going for the Terra Steel, I imagine just for the boosted Steel Stab here, but he puts the old axe on his head, looking goofy as shit, and I go for that court chain. So I bring those Toxic Spikes, I say, hey, I'm actually going to hold on to those, thank you for letting me set those up. I turn into the normal type here, which is kind of unfortunate because now at this point I don't actually resist the Make It Rain. And with that Terra Steel, it is going to be enough to take care of the Cinderace. But this thing did exactly what it needed to do, and that was get the Toxic Spikes. So, the Golden Go going for that Terra actually puts it in a position to where now Zangoose can freely go for the Facade. And I mostly just have to worry about that Dragapult in the back. But I go into Ambipom here. I know that with this thing being Scarfed once again, I can easily just outspeed in the range the thing is in. I can just knock it out. I do come in and get poisoned by my own Toxic Spikes, so it probably looks ridiculous at this point, and they're probably thinking, literally, what the hell, what's going on? But I just go for the knockoff here, and they actually do end up switching into the Dragapult. I get the prediction correct, and while it's not quite enough to knock this thing out, it does put it in range just for another to kill even without an item, and luckily, since I'm a Choice Scarf Monkey, I'm super quick out here, and I also just barely live my own poisoning, so I am just going to go for another knockoff that is going to take care of the Dragapult, and they now have half of their team left, and unfortunately Ambipom is going to go down to our own poison, which, you know, is the bad part about this strategy, but we did exactly what we needed to do. They now have no longer a switch in into the Facade. They do still have the Noivern in the back, who is extremely fast and scary, but I now have an even scarier Zangoose who can get that Toxic Boost and the benefit of the Choice Scarf, so they're going to end up switching into that Noivern, who is essentially their win condition at this point, as it likely outspeeds everything, but they do not know the strategy behind the Zangoose. So I come in, I'm able to get that poison, and with the Choice Scarf, we should be just fast enough to be able to outspeed this thing, and at this point we've been conserving our Terra just for as much possible damage. Listen, we now get extra stab boost on the normal type. I go for that Terra normal, put a diamond on my head as if Zangoose needed to look any more badass. And with extra stab on the normal type Facade at 140 base power with that Toxic Boost, There's not much in the damn world that wants to take an attack from this little fella. So, I do outspeed, we go for that facade, and of course that is going to absolutely facade this bitch to smithereens. And you absolutely love to see Zangoose doing things that it's not really supposed to do. So, with our big ass tail, we now are feeling good. That thing is taken care of. We obviously take a little bit of the poison damage, but it's the price of doing business, baby. Now they can just go right into the Ditto. Now, ordinarily Ditto, with a Choice Scarf, is able to outspeed Pokemon that it goes with the Imposter. But since I'm also Choice Scarf, I am going to be faster than their Ditto. And that Ditto being around is honestly always scary. But my Zangoose is in fact faster because I'm the OG. And a Facade is obviously easily gonna take care of the Goop. So Ditto being taken care of, the Noivern, biggest threat on the field. Now their final Pokemon is going to be that Goldengo. But of course, I am faster because of that Choice Scarf, and even though it is steel type, it's at low enough health to where easily we actually probably do a huge amount to this thing regardless, but being able to outspeed is fun. Choice Scarf Zangoose is not something I've ever used before, and I thought it was just fun to try at this team. It was a big payoff at the end. It doesn't always go exactly how you expect it's gonna, but we're able to pull off the strategy, and Zangoose is able to win the match for us, so that is gonna do it. Thank you guys very much for watching. Listen, if you enjoyed this team, let me know. I do plan on using this some more in some future videos and seeing if we can get this to do some work. I have some more fun shenanigans in the back with this as well. So let me know what you guys thought, and I will catch you next time. Peace out.